Hi friends, it's Nancy, and it is Sunday. So Sunday typically means it's self-care Sunday. But we're also working on this antique technology journal. We're almost done, actually. And in fact, tomorrow's video will be the next page. But today's video, the page comes after tomorrow's page, if that makes any sense. So I guess what I want to say is tomorrow's page is page 25, but no, today's page is 23. Yeah, tomorrow's is, I don't know what tomorrow is. Tomorrow's 21. Okay. Today is 23. Well, it doesn't really matter what order they go in. I mean, come on, Nance, relax. But I knew that this one was going to take some extra time, and most of the videos this week have been fairly short. So I've got another piece of that tea dyed single-sided scrapbook paper that I got at the thrift store. Going to fold that in half. So today is August the 6th. It's my brother's birthday. Happy birthday. He doesn't know what I'm doing. I don't know why I bother. So I want to do a pocket here, and I was thinking I would either use this picture or I would use this picture. Let's use that picture. So I want the pocket to be fairly tall, and as wide as the paper. I think. So the paper is like 4 and a chunk. So happy long weekend to my Canadian viewers. I hope you're having an absolute blast this weekend, or if not, at least relaxing. Yeah, it's about 4 1/8, so I'm going to cut this 4 1/4, and then I can trim off anything. Okay. I think it should be okay, but I'm just going to reinforce this. Because why not? I my neighbor's taking out his Harley. I don't know if you heard that or not, but it was pretty darn loud. Yeah. So I'll glue this down. I'm off camera, aren't I? I'm totally off camera. You know how I know? Because there's nothing in front of me. It's all like in line with my armpit. So I want to make another flippy flappy thing. So I have this, this is a page from a 1920s National Geographic. So I've got this little glue strip there. So I'm just going to lift this up and glue that down. That was so silly. I should have cut this first. Now I'm going to have problems. Will that fit under there? Barely. Barely. Okay, I'll try not to cut that. There. And then this flap over like so. Now on this side, I'm gonna do an envelope here, but I thought I'm gonna use the back of this envelope instead of the front of an envelope, just for something different. So I'll probably need to cut like an eighth and a smidge from each end. So there's a smidge and an eighth. So four and an eighth and a smidge. That's how we do it here. Four and an eighth. is like so. A 4 and an 1/8 and a smidge is like that. Let's see if that works. So this is from 1890, so that's a good age. Now there's a little torn piece of paper there. I think I'm gonna leave that. I think I'll ink everything up first though, because this 134-year-old paper isn't quite looking old enough for me. Works for me. Okay. Alrighty. Yeah, tried to get a few little rolls, tears. My little Timmy Holtz thing here. Yeah, that looks good. I'm going to turn this into a sort of a pocket by closing this edge up. And then you can just slide something in there. All right. Now what? Okay. Let's think about some ephemera. So I have a couple of things pulled out here that I would like to make something out of. Let's just see what I can find. Okay, I have this picture of a lady. Nah. These are from an old encyclopedia. There's a postcard. And so this is called The Pleasures of Photography. And this is 1908. So here they are. They're learning to focus. And they're developing the negative. But this one, I think I'll go with this one because there's not as much color. All right. Now. I was going to use these for something. I changed my mind. Okay. Kind of like this diagram that shows this is a telephone transmitter. And this is the receiver. So this is the part you would speak into, and this is the part you would listen out of, like on a like one of these old-fashioned candlestick telephones. That's what they're called, right? So I think I will make a something out of that. What have I got that I can... Oh, you know what I have? Where's that scrap? I'm going to put on this scrap. There we go. It's microscopically too wide. How about this side? That's a hair's breadth. Let's ink you up. I'm gonna handwrite here. There's another good journal card. What could I put in here? Will this fit in there? Maybe not. So what's your earworm today? I've had the same song in my head for days, it feels like. I like tearing paper when it tears properly. Need a hunk of book page. Hoping I can find something right there. No, I have to go look. Thank you. So here's another little tip for you. If you can't figure out which way the grain of the paper is going, and I never can, although I understand there is such a thing, tear your shortest side first, and then if you've messed up, you haven't messed up too long. Almost looks just the same, doesn't it? I'm just going to stick that little thing in there. All right. Lady. Oh, what do we need to put in a lady? We gotta put something in our lady. Where did our typewriters go? Three of those, or I could do down, and that leaves the whole back for journaling. Let's see if that'll work. You don't know till you try. I wonder what Doug's up to. I haven't seen him yet. Hope he's not getting into trouble somewhere. Okay. So, this is about 10 inches. Hmm. this doesn't fit, I'm gonna be really cross. Really super cross. It fits, it fits. I wish I had folded it the other way though. So I will. Nothing like a good set of encyclopedias to round out your journaling goodies. That white page from the National Geographic is looking at me weird. There we go. Beautiful. All right. That goes in there. Tomorrow's journal is next. The very last page is a book page. And I just popped an eyelet in there with a little bit of vintage seam binding. You'll get a better look at tomorrow's video. Tomorrow. This is ready to sew together. I'm super excited. I also need to make two more pieces of ephemera, a ticket some sort of piece of ephemera there, and also something here. So, but otherwise, this bad boy can be sewn together. I'm super happy with that. Oh, missed a page. Anyway, I hope you're enjoying your Sunday and you'll make sure to take a little time for yourself. Do a little self-care Sunday in. And yeah, we'll talk to you again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.